Michelle, how you doing?
Good, how are
good
you?
To see you.
Hey, this is Michelle Getzinger here, and I'm at one of my favorite men's clothing stores in Pittsburgh at Joseph Orlando's, and I'd like to introduce you to Joseph himself.
Thank you for the kind words. Our business was established in 1981. My father established the business. He had been in the clothing business for 25 years previous to that, so he's kind of a Pittsburgh legend in the clothing industry.
So about 4 years ago, my husband and I were looking for some unique suit ideas for him, and we couldn't find what we were looking for at other men's clothing stores, so we stumbled upon Joseph Orlando, and from the second that we walked in the door, we absolutely loved the place. The customer experience here has just been incredible. I just felt like a member of the family from day one. So tell us a little bit about this area as part of your customer experience.
So this area, you know, and one of the things that's, you know, our industry has been spoken about a lot is because with all the online shopping, if you have a brick and mortar store, one of the things you need to do is create an experience as opposed to just walking in to a store nameless and picking something off a rack and taking it to a checkout counter and paying for it, because that's basically buying it online without any experience. So there needs to be a little bit more of a personal experience, and we created this one section of our store, which is our it's called a custom salon. So it's an old waiting room at the bank, and you can see that it's got glass partitions. We have a turntable which we play vinyl on Saturday afternoons and Saturday mornings. But this allows someone to come in, sit down. We can offer them a coffee, something a little stronger than a coffee. We have a little bar over there. They can sit down, they can comb through fabric swatches. We measure them back here, and it just allows them to be separate from the rest of the store so that it's a little more exclusive, a little more of an experience. So one of the things that we've done as a business over the past couple seasons and going forward, we're going to focus on it even more, is to get brands in our store that you, first of all, can't buy them online. They're artisanal brands. This particular brand here is a company from Italy, from Puglia. It's a father and three sons, that have this clothing company, tailored clothing company. Rich is wearing one of their jackets. It's made 100% made in Italy. Most of their jackets have stretch, which gives an incredible amount of comfort. But more importantly, this is made by people that take pride. This isn't mass produced. These are people that, you know, have a passion for the fashion industry. These are made, like I said, in southern Italy, and the price point on these is very approachable because in southern Italy, the labor costs are much lower than northern Italy, where a lot of Italian clothing is made. But this is something, we have several brands similar to this. This is a brand called Latore.
So Joseph, tell us a little bit about what makes you guys different than other men's clothing stores.
Well, one of the things I think that makes us stand out and separates us from some of the other men's clothing stores, Michelle, is that we offer, if you make a purchase here, we offer free in-house tailoring. We have an open tailor shop in our store that is manned by Frank, who is a master tailor. He's been here since the day we opened. He immigrated from Italy. He's been a tailor since he's been 12 years old.
Wow.
There's no charge for this service. And I think that separates us from a lot of places that don't have that luxury.
So I remember coming down to Pittsburgh with my mom and looking at the Christmas display for Kaufman's.
Sure.
And Pittsburgh has changed so much since then. How has it, in your opinion, how has it changed since the 80s when you started?
Yeah, so, you know, one of the things, I think one of the major things that's happened is back in the 80s, nobody lived down in downtown Pittsburgh. There was one building, Gateway Towers. I think that was the only residential spot in the whole town, and at 5 o'clock downtown Pittsburgh was a ghost town, because everybody fled to whatever suburb that they lived in, and there was no activities in the evening at all, and you know, so That's the biggest change, I think, that people actually live down here. Mm-hmm. There's restaurants to go to. There's many more attractions than it used to be.
And it's really exciting. You're having 180 high-end apartments right across the
Right next door, wow. next door to us, and there is a brand new boutique hotel going directly across the street, which will be good. Mm-hmm. Any kind of support or additional businesses that surround your business mm-hmm. are usually a help.
Thank you again so
Michelle,
much.
Michelle, it's always our pleasure. Thank you so much.
It.
And I look forward to seeing you and Marty again soon.
Yep.
Thank you again for all your patronage and for spreading the good word.
Until
we appreciate
next time.
All right,
See
thanks.
Bye.
Have a great day.
Mm-hmm.